Hey everyone, it's Professor Dave, and I want to tell you some things about ozonolysis.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
So, ozonolysis is a reaction that utilizes ozone as a reagent. Ozone is a triatomic allotrope of oxygen that exists as a Zwitter ion here. So that's ozone, that's the stuff up in the atmosphere. Ozonolysis utilizes an alkene substrate, and what happens is that this double bond gets cleaved and pulled apart, and each of the carbons that was participating in this double bond is now a carbonyl. So this is useful for transforming alkenes into ketones and aldehydes. So we won't look at the mechanism here, but that is available on the internet for you to take a look at. It's a little bit interesting to look at. But the reason this is a very useful reaction is because we can do some things like transforming terminal alkenes into aldehydes, which is something that can be very useful for synthesis. So basically, anytime you're looking at an ozonolysis reaction, remember that we are cleaving that double bond and pulling apart the fragments, and on each of the carbons that was participating in the double bond, we will place an oxygen atom, and it will be in the form of a carbonyl. So here, we're generating this aldehyde and formaldehyde, which can easily be separated, and we've changed the functionality of a part of this molecule, which may be useful for the next step in a synthesis. The other thing that's interesting about ozonolysis is if you perform ozonolysis on a cyclic alkene, you won't then get two molecules, you will simply pull apart that ring and get one linear product. So here, this is useful to number sometimes when we have cyclic structures like this. So we want to take these seven carbons, and so it's very easy to draw an incorrect product if we don't do something like numbering the carbons, because what this is going to do for us is show us that if we cleave this double bond and pull that molecule apart, we know that the resulting carbonyls, when we draw the linear product, must be on carbons 2 and 7, because those were the carbons that were participating in the double bond. So that's just a trick to help you draw the correct ozonolysis product. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me with questions, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.